When the criminal justice system came to bear in my case, I was no longer able to discuss the circumstances surrounding my contact with Ms. Securro. Although I was able to make some limited statements from my attorneys, I was otherwise not free to discuss this matter. 22 years ago last month, I crossed a line in the standards of conduct with Liz Securro. I regretted that conduct immediately afterwards and since. I always wanted to find some form of effective closure for both of us. When I first reached out to Ms. Securro, I did my utmost to keep our email dialogue open and full of human understanding. When she asked me to tell her what I remember about this night, I did my best to answer. As my answer seemed to anger her, I stepped back. My only purpose in contact now was to bring peace to our lives. In the hope that we bring enough peace to let Ms. Securro move forward, I've authorized my attorneys to seek and obtain a resolution for the case which would offer Ms. Securro closure and constitute a sufficient apology for me. As I understand it, aggravated sexual battery is an offense where the victim may not be fully aware of all the circumstances. At the time this occurred, I was a 19-year-old undergraduate, and Ms. Securro was a 17-year-old freshman. My felony conviction will have lasted and significant consequences for the rest of my life. Pleading guilty to the defense, I accept responsibility for the conduct of 22 years ago. This began as an effort to make amends. Pleading guilty today to a lesser charge, I acknowledge formally what I tried to acknowledge in my letter. 22 years ago, I harmed another person, and I've tried